You came back from rehearsal and you did the new experience. What was beautiful for me.
Second time class.
What is it? What the song? What do you say?
It's a Ladino song that she wrote. Actually, one of them, it's very famous in Turkey now. They make the Turkish words very popular right now. So we choose that song. So I sing with her one verse together. So also there's another one, Adio, that she sings on the record. Beautiful. So she sings with accompaniment. I play name for her.
Really. And you like it. It's so traditional. It's all 500 years old song. And I have the greatest privilege to be
this artist. Oh, that's my privilege too. You said that it's very popular in Turkey. The song that she singing, which means
the other one.
The other one.
She recorded already the one that audio, but the other one is the Yastayım. So I'm very sad. It's in Turkish, but she sings that too. She said it's a Ladino song.
Nice. Tell me, you don't have any problem? I know that you don't have any problem. But people ask themselves, if you don't have any problem to sing with a Jewish lady and you're a Muslim man.
I feel we are children of Adam, first of all. We believe there is no difference between the culture difference. It's illusion. Because we come from Adam. We have the same father. And over the history, people divide themselves. I am this, you are Turk, you are Greek, but actually, in essence, we are same. So also as a spiritual person, I believe in God. And because of the Creator, He creates everybody. Because of the Creator, I love all the creatures. Mm-hmm. I don't make any distinguish, even the animals, plants, and especially people, they are more divine. So it's like a rainbow, but all the color, different color, but from the same light. Mm-hmm. Go through the prism, becomes different, but actually essence is the same. So I respect, I have privilege, actually. It's,
but you know that even in your country now we see news, Islam and politics, and even here, you know, we have a conflict, Israeli-Palestinian. Do people are not criticize you because of what you're doing?
No, actually I get compliment about it because
no politics, no criticism.
No, so far no, because I believe musicians and artists, our duty should be above political ideology, all this. We have to relieve people's spirit. We have to give them peace. Remind them that there is a peaceful state of our spirit. So through music is the best for this. So we are just reminding them that through music, connecting to each other. So this is the best remedy, not only this time, throughout the history. This fight is never now, it's new. 3,000 years old, since the beginning of Adam. Mm-hmm. Adam has two sons, one of them killed his brother, right? Yeah. So this exists, when human beings have that possession always, uses religion or use politics, this, to overcome some other people. Yeah.
But you feel that when you're working, you got this attitude, you feel criticism or something?
Yeah. No, I believe, I mean, I also work with Muslims, musicians, Christians, Jews. I mean, there's no place in my life for doing this. I mean, this thing that we're talking about, it's natural, and this is our language, is music. And I don't believe that I can change the world, but the only way I can make a little difference is through making music with people from three religions. And that's how I live. This is the way I live. I know that's how he lives.
Tell me. I studied Islam and I know about the Sufis. It's amazing. It's something so unique, so clean. So it's a new light, I would say, in Islam. You play the Sufi music in your repertoire. Why the Sufis are not so strong in the Islam that we see today?
Actually, I should say, first of all, Sufism, even though flourished through Islam, but Sufism exists in the root of every religion, because we believe in the first Sufi was the Idris alayhi salam, which is the second prophet after Adam, like they call him also Hermes. So that was the first declare that Sufism, in essence, have, to my understanding, two basic things. One is the adoration of Lord, the Creator, we adore Him. And then, second, because of the Creator, they love all the creatures, without any prejudgment. That's why Sufis have biggest tolerance to the people. They don't judge people. They see them as an example to us, and then whatever they see toward the good or bad, they apply themselves. And then they become example. So that's why they are so tolerant. So in Islam, actually, in a sense of Islam, and in every religion, they teach love, tolerance and love. So Sufism has the peak of it. That's why they never criticize people. They criticize themselves, and then they become a good example to the people and love.
How do you feel when you see that people use the Islam for political purpose and doing extreme things in the name of Islam?
It's not, of course, good. It's not only Islam, in the Crusader, in the Christianity, or in every nation, every religion, because religion is so powerful. Some uneducated people, they can be motivated easily because they have fear, because religion imposed the, you go to Jahannam, you go to hell, and this in the name of God, even though it's not true, that what they do. So in the name of God, they motivate people toward their need, what they want to move. So I don't think it's the fault of Islam or other religion. It's the smart people, they know that they can motivate people through the fear or in the name of God. So that's it. I don't think we should blame the religion because of it. Mm-hmm.
Tell me, are you going to play together in the mosque in Sahmin on Friday?
Yes, we are going to play. She's not going to be Friday. She's not going to
be religious. Keep Shabbat.
Okay. So you respect her?
That's why we don't criticize the people. You have to respect as they are.
Nice. So what is going to be in the mosque? Can you tell us what exactly?
No, as far as I know, we are going to village. They invited us. They will raise the hospital. And then also we will meet those Sufi Abul Palestine, his name. So we're going to meet them, inshallah. Then we will do some gatherings. If we do, they do some prayer, of course, I will join them. Mm-hmm. So they will do some zikr, I think that's what it is. But whatever their style, I am like water. I can go of everything because I'm very sincere. Whoever you do in the name of God, I let my soul go into it. I respect everybody's way.
You know, people that will watch this interview will say in their heart, we wish that all the people would be like you. Do you think that one day all the Islam, all the Judaism, all the Christianity, especially the Islam, you know, because there's a lot of people who believe in Islam, and there is a lot of people that are taking advantage of the Islam. So do you think that the Sufism will win one day, will prevail? Because, you know, there's a lot of people who hate them. Even the regimes in the Middle East, they don't allow Sufism to work.
Yeah, because Sufism, at the beginning, you know, the Orthodox Muslims, they thought that they are misguiding the people, making them lose to the religious rules. So even there are so many executions in the past. They kill all the Sufi people because they thought they are misleading people according to the religious rules, Sharia. But then now there are more understanding, they are getting more and more what they didn't mean to that. So they are getting more because of like Rumi kind of people. Jalaluddin Rumi is one of the Sufi, also Muhyiddin Arabi. Rumi is the best example, everybody loved him.
Yeah,
so he was following the Sharia also, the rule of Islam, but he talked about the Sufism, which is what Sufism is for us.
Do you think the Prophet Muhammad was like his style?
Of course, the essence of religion is you say the religion, you tell the advice, you don't force. There is no force in Islam, in any religion. So if you say, why you don't do this, you should. You become a prophet, it's not your job. Because God gives the duty to the prophets. God selects his prophets, tell him, go, invite the people. And other than prophets, it's not people's duty to force, of course, become example. Follow the prophet's example, and then advise them. You cannot force people. So if you force, there is no force in the religion. So hopefully, but in the prophecy, there will be one day the Messiah will come and everybody will believe in one rule, one God, and then there will be golden age. So which, because Islam in a means, surrender your will to God, which is in every religion. So Abraham was the first surrender, first Khalil al-Khalil 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 al- So he was the first Muslim in Quran says, and a Muslim, because he was trying to find God in different way, and then he says, suddenly I said, oh, if I go with my mind, I am betrayed, so please God, I am the moral testing, and I surrender myself.
How do you feel when you hear speaking like this, and you live in Israel, and you know that you have a religious conflict, and sometimes we're depressed, that we said, ah, there is no end to this.
I wish everybody will be like him, and it gives me hope to know that there are people who think and like him, and I want to believe in everybody that he's not the only one, but the others are not the only one, and there are many Muslim people, you know, that thinks like him, I'm happy to be part of it.
Tell me, last question, do you have any suggestions for the Israeli and the Palestinian how they can solve the problems here?
Well, not only for this particular people, Israeli, also, but all the conflicts as a human being comes when they get out from themselves, because our duty is train ourselves, supposed to be, and then be example. That's the only way we can change the world. If we stop talking ourselves and stop to talk to people, you should do this, you should do this, rather than say, I should do, then there is no end for this. The only way, everybody should correct themselves. First, ask themselves, be good, then be example. That's what a real imam is. Imam is not only leading the people, lead his nafis, your own nafis, your own self, become imam to yourself.
Then, reflects to
then you reflect with your own acting. Not talking, but your act. So if people start to talk themselves, how it's supposed to be, as a husband, as a wife, as a lawyer, as a driver, whatever, if they do the best of whatever they are, then the world will be peaceful.
Yeah, I do believe in it.
Yeah, I should respect people who are different from us. We should respect people. This is our problem. We don't respect
them. Yeah, I think it's what I say. It's the same thing also, because they are getting out of themselves. And they told, oh, you should do this. This is disrespect.
When you think about the other and not about first about yourself in everything, like you said, in couplehood, in the work, in the job, in everything. First it's you, and then it's the other.
But unfortunately, people sit down and they always criticize the other self. So they're disrespecting, because you cannot see what in that people's mind and the spirit completely as they are. So you know yourself. So you tell yourself, you do your job, and then respect whatever they are, and then listen to them. Then there will be more harmony and peace.
So what you think when you see all this Hamas and Al-Qaeda and all those organizations, what do you think in your heart? What do you say to yourself?
I feel pity, because in a way they are trying to let them hurt people, because they feel that they cannot express themselves, they cannot hurt by the people. So they choose the violation. Okay, we are here, you can hear us. That's the motivation. But history proved that if you choose the violation to be heard, to be listened by people, it doesn't work. Because shedding the blood, killing innocent people in the name of making yourself right, it's not that God said, don't, you shall not kill. You cannot kill people. Of course, you gotta speak with the right and then just protect yourself. I respect whatever people do, but I choose not to be violent, because violence brings violence. Only way is like Gandhi. Gandhi was the best example for this. Because all the English, everything they do, they just don't react. He motivated the people, don't react. They didn't do whatever they did, they just waited. And then all the more they hurt them. So I think this is the most powerful way of being hurt by people, whatever is right. Unfortunately, they are all people. I feel sorry for them too. They should be in the good place, of course. Everybody should live good, this, but unfortunately, the method that people choose violence is not the bringing the peace.
Okay, thank you very much for this. Such a
place. As soon as light is there, dark is not there. The dark is illusion.
Yes. Okay, my friend, I won't give you my card in the car. I don't know if you are going to see.
Yeah.
Thank you.